I have to take it off mute before I can talk.
Before you say hello, yes. Fellow streakers.
Hello there, fellow streakers.
I wondered, I'm like, he's talking, but I can't hear a thing
he's saying.
Welcome to our morning.
Yes. Fellow streakers, it is good to be talking with you again. We started last podcast starting a conversation about what makes a good life, lessons from the longest study on happiness. If you didn't get a chance to listen to that podcast, you may want to listen to that one first before you listen to this one, because this is the continuing conversation.
This literally is part two. We kind of ended in the... It was a cliffhanger.
It was a I don't know if it was a cliffhanger or not, but I'll tell you this. We got a lot more to say.
We have a lot more to say.
I think that as we continue to talk about this, but one of the things in the continuation of this conversation... And by the way, if you're just joining us for the first time, and you are part of the new audience that is out there, and I'm just amazed at how many new people we have added to the audience every single week. I mean, it is absolutely phenomenal. If you're just new to it, I'm Jeff. That's Jamie.
And I'm Pointer. Over here. Hi.
Over there. Hi. How are you? And we have conversations about streaking. No, not that kind of streaking. Not the kind where you're running across the football field naked. It's all about the ways to get consistency in your life in order to become who you want to be. And so we apply the laws of streaking in a whole bunch of different situations. For the month of February, we're talking about relationships and what it is that you do with relationships and how you can apply streaking to relationships. What we're talking about right now is really the culmination of all of that. This study was quite significant. As Jamie, you found it in one of your streaks. It really applies to everything that we've been discussing.
And it's so funny that I found it kind of at the end of our discussion. I mean, it was towards the end of February that I just listened to this TED Talk.
Right.
Because it just put kind of an exclamation point on what we were talking about.
Right.
That streaking is a way to help improve relationships.
Right.
And good relationships is the way to happiness and good health.
Yeah.
Like having good relationships in your life, the way you treat people, the effort that you put into building those lasting relationships is truly what makes us happy. It's not being rich. It's not being famous. In fact, I've often thought that being famous is probably one of the worst things we can do to people.
Why is that? Some people really like it.
Because
I don't think it's a bad thing.
It's because it places a lot of expectation on people to have to be a certain way all the time.
Okay.
It doesn't allow them to be human. It doesn't allow them to make mistakes. We place this, you know, you have to, and living your life on stage for a whole group of people, that'd be tough.
Yeah.
Because the minute you
some
live,
people really relish in that.
Some
though.
People I mean, really
some
relish
people
in it.
Really
that's true.
Enjoy
but I
being
don't
on
know
stage
that they,
and being up at up.
Not that being on stage, but just being on stage is different than being famous.
Hmm.
I don't know. I just think being famous is a harsh taskmaster. I wouldn't want it. I used to think I would want it, but as I've grown older, I've
what
thought,
if fame
I
is just forced upon
be,
you, and it's not that
I
you
will
want
reject
it, but you,
it. I reject fame. You can.
Because I'll tell you right now, there's a lot of people who like listening to what you have to say.
It's fine. You can like listening, but I'm not going to be famous.
You're not going to inhale that one, huh?
Nope. No fame here.
I love it. I love where you're going with that.
So when we were talking about this study.
Hold on just a second before we get to it's about the study, but I wanted to state something right up front. I think that the B statement, because what we often talk about in streaking is who do you want to be? And clearly delineating who you want to be, whether it be a broad statement or a very narrow statement. And let me give you an example of those two. So a broad statement of a B statement is, I want to be happy and healthy. That's pretty broad.
Very
I mean,
broad.
There's a lot of different ways to do that. We're going to talk about one specific way that is proven overall what makes you happy and healthy most of the time. But that's pretty broad. Or I want to give to the world, something like that. Very broad statements. And that's fine. And that's but delineating and saying a B statement. Now, a very narrow B statement may be, I want to be a neurosurgeon.
Right. Very specific.
Or I want to be a world-leading or world-class neurosurgeon. Mm-hmm. Now you're talking about a very specific area. However, both are B statements. And the reason why the B statement is important is because it gives direction to what you need to do to become that person. So with this study and what you and I have been talking about, I've been thinking, who do I want to be? I want to be someone who is healthy and happy, and therefore I'm going to look at different areas that will help me understand how to be healthy.
That's okay. In the last podcast, I said remembery.
Remembery.
Because that's the word one of our kids used.
I'm yeah,
like,
Chance
yeah, you
says
have a good remembery. And I'm like, that's not actually a word.
It is now.
In it the is Downs in the Downs family. In the remembery Downs lexicon, is a remembery. Word.
When I look at the B statement of, I want to be healthy and happy, studying and looking for those answers is great. And then I need to do something.
Right.
Now, I may not know what my B statement is when I start doing something, but eventually at some point, in order to continue to do whatever it is, the streak is that I'm doing, I do at some point need to understand why.
And exactly. That's what I was going to say. The B statement becomes your why. And the why is a question that I think we always need to be asking. Why am I doing this? Because it's important. It's propelling. It's making the determination of why we're doing what we're doing.
Mm-hmm.
And so the B statement in my mind is something that is, it's not something you do once and put away and never think about. It's something that's kind of a living, breathing, evolving part of you that as you continue to grow, your B statement would evolve and grow with you. It's mm-hmm. not something that...
It's one of the reasons why I have it as a streak to write at least... Well, to write my B statement daily, at least one sentence of my B statement, because like you said, it's evolving.
There's several,
I've added to it and I've modified it and mm-hmm. I've changed it and I've done things to say, who do I really want to be? Because I love how you just put it. It is an evolving, moving, dynamic statement that I continue to grow into. And it's an aspiration. It's not something that I'm going to arrive at in this lifetime. I don't know if I will arrive at it.
And I also think sometimes...
And I'm okay with that.
Exactly. It's okay that it's being something that you're working towards and discovering, I guess. Who do I really want to be? That's sometimes something that I think can be a little daunting for people when we're saying, you should write a B statement. Who do you want to be? That can be a little overwhelming sometimes.
That's true.
To think about. And so the thing that I love about streaking is that it gives you a place to start. You're like, well, I know this much. I know I feel compelled that I want to do this thing. And then as you start doing it, you start to recognize, oh, I'm doing this because I want to be. So
right.
We felt compelled to run.
Yeah,
I did. I was like, I want to run. But as I set a streak around that, I recognized I don't want to be a professional runner. I want to be healthy. And so it opened up an understanding of what it is, what's my why behind this? And mm-hmm. I think that's a process. I love, as we got to streaking and someone said, well, you're just streaking to streak. I have thought so much about the power of the streak is in how many days in a row can you do something that it propels you to keep going.
Yeah.
And I also think it's important to recognize that when you have the why, the B statement, it also gives you the power that maybe you started with a streak that you thought, oh, this is what I want to do. This is going to take me where I want to go and who I want to be.
Yeah.
And you get partway into it and you've been doing it for, 100 or maybe you've been doing it for a year and you start to recognize and be like, this isn't what I want to do. This isn't who I want to be. This isn't taking me where I thought it would. I need to adjust it. That's okay. You can change it if you need to,
mm-hmm.
because the B statement is what is propelling this. The streaking is the how. It's what keeps it going. But it's okay to change it if you need to.
Which brings us to the study and the how I have, because they have the lessons of the longest life study on happiness. The question is how we're going to do this. So let's get back into the study here. Again, this is Dr. Robert Waldinger, director of the study, and he's the fourth director, psychiatrist at Massachusetts General Hospital, and a professor of psychiatry at Harvard Medical School.
Yep.
Okay, so with that being said, there were three things I think that you wanted to point out, because, again, you'll have to listen to the last podcast for the first part of this, so we're going to get right into the meat of it.
So from this 75-year study that they did of these men, they learned three things about relationships and why, because again, the gist of the study was that they learned good relationships keep us happier and healthier.
Period.
So he said, we've learned three big lessons about relationships. The first is social connections are really good for us. Like, we need social connections, and that loneliness kills us.
You know, that's interesting to me because sometimes I want to be a hermit. I want to be somewhat a recluse, isolated from the world. I know that sounds a little bit crazy with what kind of life I live.
Because
I'm a consultant. I'm usually on stage. I'm usually talking to large groups of people. But there's times where I just want to be a little bit more... lonely is not the word, I don't think.
I was going to say, I think being alone is different than being lonely.
Okay, good point.
Because you can be lonely in a crowd of people. You can be lonely even in your relationships. And he talks about that. So the second one is that, so this was the second, he says,
that
you can be lonely in a crowd.
Done. Taking what I said and just going right into the study.
So he said, it's not just the number of friends you have. And it's not whether or not you're in a committed relationship, but it's the quality of your close relationships that matter. So it's not just that you have the relationships, but there has to be an element of quality to those relationships.
So, okay. So that one rubs me just a little bit interestingly.
Okay.
Because I believe that quality is the great stop sign of consistency.
This idea that, well, it has to be quality. So I don't want to start or I don't want to get going until I know it's going to be quality.
Exactly.
If you can't make it quality, don't do it at all.
Exactly.
Yeah.
And I think that that is wrong. I think that quality comes through consistency. Consistency is the car on which quality rides.
Right.
Or in which quality rides. That's what I see. And so I would not get hung up on the whole idea of I don't have a quality relationship or what is a quality relationship or what does quality look like. I have noticed in my own life, and as I work with individuals and I see what they do in their lives, that the quality comes through doing it.
Through the consistency.
The laughably simple.
Yep.
Through doing laughably simple. In other words, someone who reaches out to me, their intent counts much more than their technique.
Right.
And if they're really bad at reaching out, but they do it,
it still means something.
And it should.
Mm-hmm.
I should put weight in that. And that is, so the quality of it, don't let, I would say to anyone who's listening, don't let quality stop you. Do the laughably small thing and let consistency be what will drive the quality as you keep going in life. Because as you progress, you'll get better at it. You'll figure out ways to make it better. But it's never going to happen if I'm not doing it.
Exactly.
Does that make sense?
Totally. And that's why I think I loved reading about this study, because I felt like, okay, we've got the what and the why, but where is the how?
Yeah.
And he says this, he says...
So before you go there, did you say
the third one is pretty simple, sorry.
It's like, I'll go back one real quick. And two. Yeah.
The third one is that relationships... the third thing we learned about relationships and our health is that good relationships don't just protect our bodies, but they protect our brains. So it's also healthy. So he talks a little bit about Alzheimer's, and as you get older, a relationship affects even your memory and how you function at not just a physical level,
right,
but also your brain.
Right.
So going back to what you were saying about the quality,
yes,
of the relationships, because I feel like what I hear you saying is that there's this huge emphasis on, well, it needs to be quality, but that's farther than where we start. And so it hampers our ability sometimes to be able to start, because we're like, well, it's got to be quality. But the truth of the matter is exactly what you said. Quality comes through consistency, which means there's going to be a lot of not so great quality for a while sometimes,
right,
until you get to a place that you have enough experience and enough practice and you've been doing it long enough that you're like, okay, this is quality now.
That reminds me of the conversation that we had with Craig Christensen. I mean, he was on our podcast. We did, I think, a 2 series with him. Mm-hmm. I mean, he talks about that, about, yeah, everyone's got to start.
You got to start somewhere, and none of us start great. Like, if you're going to start skiing, you're not doing black diamonds and moguls. You're starting on the bunny hill.
Exactly.
Just like we start walking.
Let's put it this way. If you start on the black diamonds and mogul, you may never ski again.
Well, and so isn't that interesting? If we say, oh, it's got to be quality, I've got to be great at it, it's actually dangerous.
Yeah,
we need to start in the places where we are. So this is what he says. So this message that good, close relationships, and this is Dr. Waldinger, thank you.
Yep.
This message that good, close relationships are good for our health and well-being, this is wisdom that is as old as the hills. So basically he's saying, we spent 75 years studying this thing, and we found that it's true, but it's not like it was new.
Right.
This has been around.
Yeah.
Why is this so hard to get and so easy to ignore, he asks. Well, because we're human. What we'd really like is a quick fix, something we can get that'll make our lives good and keep them that way.
Okay, so stop right there. This is the great hoax of habits, right here. This habits are such a huge hoax because that is what everyone thinks a habit will do.
Is that if you can just do it enough times.
If I do it enough times.
It'll be that quick
it'll
fix.
It'll just be the quick. Well,
it'll
and,
stick. It'll keep me happy.
Well,
and it'll
I think
stay
more
that
so,
way.
They may not look at it as the quick fix. I think that's sometimes the you know, the pill, pop a pill for a quick fix. Mm-hmm. I think where the hoax of habits comes in is right here where he says, we can, let's see here, something we can get that'll make our lives good and keep them that way.
Mm-hmm.
I just don't even have to think about it anymore.
If I put the effort in, it'll just stay and it'll run itself.
And that is the greatest hoax, I think, that's been perpetrated in all of progress and learning.
Mm-hmm.
That habits just make it that way. They
don't. Or that there's anything that we can just put in a lot of effort at the beginning and then stick it on autopilot and not have to think about it and it's going to turn out great.
Doesn't happen.
Just doesn't happen.
I've been trying for many, many years to make that happen and it doesn't.
Well, and apparently it's a human condition that we're
That's
all suffering
right.
with.
We're getting there. Okay, so.
Says, relationships are messy and they're complicated and the hard work of tending to family and friends is not sexy or glamorous. And then he says, it's also lifelong. It never ends.
Okay, I want to go back to something here. Relationships are messy, complicated. The hard work of tending to family and friends. What is the hard work? In my mind, the hard work is the consistency.
Exactly.
That's why I need to make something laughably simple is because it's the consistency of continuing to keep that alive. For example, send at least one text to a family member or friend daily. You know, sending a text or even let's make it, I think, even more simple is just contact in some way a family member or friend daily. I think that is the hard work, but the hard work is in the consistency.
It's in the consistency, exactly. And that's why I loved, when I read this, I like highlighted it and put a big box around it where he said, it's lifelong, it never ends.
It's an aspiration. It's an aspirational state. It's something that I'm continuing to work on all the time.
And that's what the methodology of streaking teaches us, is that there are these things that bring us happiness and health. Good relationships, but they can be messy and complicated and they take hard work and it's something we're doing our whole life and it never ends. And I thought, that's what a streak, that's the how, is you set a streak around something that you want to have in a good relationship. So I have a personal experience. My sister reached out and was like, I feel like I don't know my family as well and I want to...
This is really neat. This is a neat experience.
We're obviously adults. And so she set a streak.
Are we really adults though?
We're adults.
I don't know if it's so obvious.
Why
sometimes.
Did I need to say that? Apparently I needed to reaffirm
that you are an adult.
That we are all adults.
I don't know. Sometimes
we're
I
all
don't
adults
feel like
in
an
this
adult.
Room. But she set a streak and it's been a couple months now that she would send an email to the family every week. So each Sunday night she sends us an email and some of them have been really short. Like she's had one where she's like, this was a tough week. I've been sick. I'm doing fine. Just want you to know that I'm still alive. Kind of was.
Yes, exactly.
But then she's had other ones where they've been big, long ones that have told us about what she's doing and how
it's
she's
been
started
so
something
wonderful.
New.
And yeah.
I have felt so much closer to her because of those emails that she's sending out. And I feel connected to her.
Yeah.
And I thought that was
You know,
great.
She's a streaker.
She's a streaker. She has a streak. That's what she...
And her daughter's a streaker as well. We're going to actually highlight her daughter as a streaker in not this podcast, but in the next one. We'll talk a little bit about Lila and her streak.
And her streak.
Yeah, because it was
kind
of cool.
So I've loved that when we know that good relationships are important, we can set a streak around it because this is something you're going to be working on your whole life.
Right.
So what are some things that people can do?
I'd like to go to that with the last. So he gives one sentence on the how.
Mm-hmm.
And then I want to go a little bit more into the how. And I can't believe how fast time goes by. Well, the possibilities are practically endless. It might be something as simple as replacing. And I love how he says this.
As simple as.
Right. And I think that sometimes
replacing.
That denigrates what it is. I mean, replace. We don't replace anything. You
displace
something with a streak. Simple as. And. and I'll say displace. He says replace. Displace screen time with people time, or livening up a stale relationship by doing something new together, long walks or date nights, or reaching out to a family member who you haven't spoken to in years, because those all too common family feuds take a terrible toll on the people who hold grudges. That's it. That's the only sentence he gives on the how. So you ask the question, you know, what are some of the streaks that you can set, the how to do this? And I think that one of the streaks that I have is to connect with at least one of my children daily.
Mm-hmm.
And the connect is a little bit higher quality than just contact, but I have both of them. I have contact at least one child daily and connect with one child daily. And the connection is really, I'm looking at them in the eyes and I'm genuinely interested in what they've done for their day.
Right.
I think that I could do that also with friends or other family members.
Mm-hmm.
And I can do that on a weekly or daily basis. What else do you
have? You've mentioned that you know someone that has a streak to send a thank you note every week.
Yes.
And we have another friend who has a streak to send an uplifting text message.
I feel like we're just going so fast to try and get all this in.
I guess there are things that we've talked about, but mostly what I want to say is think about the relationships in your life. And it's okay if you don't know exactly where to start. Just pick something simple, and start. One streaker we talked to had a streak to kiss her husband every day. That was her streak, to give her husband at least once a kiss daily. And another one to hug a child daily, to send one person had a leave a note of encouragement. So she would do a post-it note to someone every day.
Mm-hmm.
Just something that says, just these little things that we can do. And the streak is what gives you that consistency. You said it's laughably simple, something laughably simple. Make sure that it doesn't have the dependencies, that you're able to be able to do it no matter what situation your life may be in.
Right.
And then keep a record of it. And then the community, that's what I've loved. The whole result of this study is saying that the community that we live in is what makes us happy.
Absolutely.
And healthy.
Yeah.
Having that community around us.
Here's where I'd like to, I don't have time to end up on this, but he basically said this: the people who were most satisfied in their relationships at age 50 were the healthiest at age 80. And good close relationships seem to buffer us from some of the slings and arrows of getting old.
Yep. So streaking can help improve your relationships.
Just do it.
Just think about it and set a streak.
Who do you want to be? And do what you need to do to be that person. And the way you become that person is by doing the laughably small things every day or every week. Well, we love and enjoy speaking with you. Jamie, it's been great.
This is awesome.
Until the next one, keep streaking. And, well, I was going to say, if you want to let us know what some of your streaks are, Jeffrey, Jefferey at streakingmastery.com.
Or Jamie, Jami, at streakingmastery.com.
Until we talk with you again,
keep streaking.
Become a better you. It's the small and simple things that make you grow into what you're hoping.